Did you know that since last month, you probably spent 60 hours online, logged on about 57 times, and visited more than 2,000 web pages? And since you started this video, more than 10 million emails have been sent. Of course, you probably didn't even notice it. The internet is now completely integrated to our daily lives. Everyone can find what he needs for any kind of activity, such as emailing, reading news, online banking, shopping, social networking. On the whole, there are 2 billion internet users in the world today, 70% of which use it every day. There is no doubt that the internet has revolutionized our interaction and communication with the world, much like the invention of the printing press or the telegraph. But what is exactly at stake in this revolutionary phenomenon? The Googleization of the world, of which we are both actors and objects, has created a system whose impact might be bigger than we understand. So much of the data and information we disclose on our web pages are far from being totally controlled by us, nor are they lost or deleted.
Have you ever heard of big data? Well, that's what it's about. While individual pieces of information are not very valuable, when compiled and analyzed in then the aggregates, companies can study our daily behaviors today to better anticipate our needs for tomorrow. But big data also has a downside. With the growing impact of the internet on our lives comes an increase in the amount of personal data we disclose online, some of which we wouldn't normally agree to share with anyone but our closest friend. Without even realizing, tracking technologies often keep a precise record of when and to whom you email, what you read, what you listen to and watch, what you buy, and what you're interested in. This information provides a goldmine for the large companies that control the data and can define their entire economic and marketing strategies around it. Moreover, as the recent NSA spying revelations in the United States have shown, police and security agencies of many countries are accessing and examining data relating to our communications in the name of national security. Should our enjoyment of online privacy be sacrificed in favor of our economic or security concerns?
EU institutions have tried to address these issues. On the one hand, in 1995, the EU passed a data protection directive that prohibits EU companies from crunching your data, unless they do it in a transparent and legitimate way. On the other hand, in response to the realities of our post-9/11 world, the EU passed in 2006 a data retention directive that requires member states to ensure that all electronic and telephone communication data is retained and stored for up to 2 years, which can be momentarily accessed by police and security agencies if needed for the interest of public safety. Does this directive respect individual fundamental rights of privacy? Does it hinder individuals' freedom of expression and even the right to free movement? All of these questions are important, not just because they affect how we live our lives, but because they are all being deliberated by European leaders as we speak. A proposal to reform the Data Protection Directive is currently being considered by the European Parliament, but the European leaders are stuck in debate, leaving the future of data protection uncertain. The Data Retention Directive is being challenged by national courts as violations of fundamental rights across the continent, and the issue has just been heard in front of the European Court of Justice. Its Advocate General has given his opinion that the program of massive data collection does not comply with fundamental rights of privacy, but as to how the actual court may rule, well, all bets are off.
Our project involves meeting with European public leaders and professionals in order to understand more clearly what the reality of data protection is and what the stakes are, and then to react with our own policy proposals. But since the right to privacy is a matter of public interest, we need to build our work through the opinions and voices of European citizens.
What do they want from the EU regarding their fundamental rights? What are their concerns? And moreover, how do they expect to be protected from outsiders' intrusion in their digital life?
Because you're concerned as much as anyone else, we need your help. Join this project and help ensure that the European Union leaders currently debating these issues understand how you feel about the increasing commercial and security use of your personal data.
Thank you.